In this video, I want to talk about extension utils. The reason I'm making this video is that I'm seeing some extensions creating their own functions for getting gsettings and initiate translation. Almost all extension developers are familiar with getCurrentExtension function and know how to import extension utils. For those who don't know how to do it, this is the import line. This is extensionUtils source code, and you can find it in GNOME Shell repository. If you scroll down, you can see getCurrentExtension function here. Next function is init translations. If you don't send the domain here, it will get it from gettext-domain in metadata.json file. For example, I have gettext-domain key in my own extension like this. When you are using init translation function, you should use local folder for your translation files. For example, I'm doing this in my own extension. I can also drop the first parameter since I have proper key in my metadata. Next function in extension utils is getSettings. You can use settings-schema key in your metadata.json file. As you can see, I use this key in metadata file. And this is how I get gSettings object. While you are allowed to use init translation in init function, we will reject your extension if we see getSettings in init function. I see some extensions using a spun command to open preferences dialog. Stay away from a spun command until you really have to use it. To open preferences dialog, use openprefs function instead. You probably don't need to use the other functions here. If you need any help with your extension, you can ask us on GNOME Matrix channel. As always, if you want to support my work, the Patreon link is in the description. Thanks.